السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أناديه ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازيه. نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، إلها واحدا أحدا فردا صمدا قيوما. نؤمن له بالربوبية ونقر له بالعبودية. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأوصياء والصديقين وعترة نبيك الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين وأصحابه المنتجبين ومن تبعهم بإحسان وإيمان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره في هذا الشهر العظيم. قال تعالى في كتابه الكريم، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا. اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Three main things that shape our personality and who we are. Number one, our thoughts and our ideology, the things that we believe in, the things that we follow, the things that we embrace. The second is the character, the moral character, our akhlaq, our moral traits, moral qualities also determines our personality. And thirdly, our behavior and our conduct and how the way we carry ourselves. These three, the combination of these three elements presents your personality. And this is your identity. This is who you are. And each and every person of us needs a period of accountability, a period of self-examination and self-reflection. And thus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides many opportunities for us to examine ourselves, to do muhasaba, accountability, to ask ourselves, hold ourselves accountable, question ourselves about these three areas, about our thoughts, our characters, and our behavior. And we have to change. Each and every person today needs to change himself or herself. This life is a continuous journey of mental, physical, spiritual, and religious growth. We should not be stuck in a perpetual cycle of childhood and infanthood. We need to grow. We need to learn. And the month of Ramadan is the time, the season for us to grow, the season for us to change. Maybe throughout the year, we don't have this opportunity because we are busy with our life. We are super busy. People are running. People have been turned into robots, running for their life to survive in this life. We don't have that opportunity. We don't slow down throughout the year. We are always busy. And also, the other element that does not allow us to reflect and self-examine is we do not have enough courage to change ourselves. Sometimes we are aware of our weaknesses. We know them. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا. We are aware of what is going on. We are aware of our faults, our mistakes, our weaknesses, but we do not have enough determination. We do not have enough power to break free from the bad habits and to change ourselves. The month of Ramadan provides us this opportunity to garner enough courage to change ourselves through the Quranic recitation. لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ رَبِيعٌ وَرَبِيعُ الْقُرْآنِ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ إِنَّ هَذِهِ الْقُلُوبِ تَصْدَأُ كَمَا يَصْدَأُ الْحَدِيدِ قِلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَمَا جَلَاؤُهَا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, these hearts, human hearts, they become rusty, just like the iron rod when it becomes rusty. So they said, how do we polish it? How do we refine it? فَمَا جَلَاؤُهَا قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قِرَاءَةُ الْقُرْآنِ. Focus on your Quranic recitation. This is the month of the Quran. مَنْ تَلَى فِيهِ آيَةٍ. The Prophet صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ says, has been reported to say, that if you recite an ayah, you get the reward of one khatma, as if you have read the whole Quran, the reward of it. بِغَيْرِهِ مِنَ الشُّهُورِ. This is the time for us to change. And the change begins with us from inside. Allah provide us with this opportunity. First, we come to the ideas. Many of us, we carry certain ideologies or thoughts that are not correct. We have, this life is a struggle for us. Continuous struggle with our thoughts. We have to examine them. We should not take our thoughts for granted. Things that we learn from our parents or the school or the environment or the neighborhood. And we believe that these are the most correct, most authentic. I don't have to change them. Allah has given us the brain, the intellectual power. So we debate, we discuss. الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. Bayan is the intellectual speech, intellectual discourse. So we discover new things. If we are happy with our own ideas and we think all are wrong and we are the only people who are right, this is very dangerous. We are under a great illusion. We have to debate, always debate, always have intellectual debate about our ideology, our thoughts. We learn. We learn. Allah enables us. عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ. Insan came into this life with zero knowledge. He can become the most knowledgeable. So we have to try to change and examine our thoughts, our ideology. And one of them is the deen, the madhab. Am I really on the right track? Am I doing the right thing? We have to debate. And alhamdulillah, there are books, there are scholars. Nowadays, knowledge is not limited to few circles in this city or that city. You can reach knowledge anytime, any minute. You can debate, you can ask. This is number one. The second is we have to reflect on our characters. Sifat, as-sifatun nafsiyyah. Some psychologists, anthropologists, sociologists, or even ethicists, ulama al-akhlaq, they believe that you are born with your own character. You cannot change. You cannot change yourself. While the Quran says, yes, you can change yourself. If you have some bad habits, you can change them. إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم. تغيير. Allah says transformation. You can change yourself, but it depends on you. It depends on yourself, on your determination. You can change. Some ethicists, علماء الأخلاق, they say الصفة تابعة للإرادة. Your character follows your determination. Not that your determination follows your character, no. The character follows your determination. If you have determination, if you decide to do something, you can change your own character. From being bad into being good, or sometimes from being good into being bad. So someone who is dishonest and he thinks that he has been dishonest for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, still he or she can change himself. From being dishonest to being an honest person. From being someone who's a liar into someone who's being truthful. Into someone who does not know the meaning of organization or discipline. Into someone who is very disciplined and very organized. From someone who has no dutifulness towards his parents or his family. No responsibility towards his children, his wife. From being someone who is highly responsible. الصفة, the character, our characters, follows our determination. We can do that. We can change ourselves. But then we have to sacrifice. It does not come free. Every change entails a price tag. You have to sacrifice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided us with the month of Ramadan. We are sacrificing now. At this minute, most of you are sacrificing when you don't eat, when you don't drink, when you refrain, when you abstain from certain things during the day of Ramadan. This is a type of sacrifice. Allah wants you to carry on, to continue this journey of sacrifice and take it to a higher level, not just food or a drink. There are something that are certain things that are more difficult than food or a drink. Desires. Desires for certain things, more difficult. Allah wants you to continue this. And He enables you, He provides you. The month of Ramadan is the month of self-reflection, my friends. Do not forget the dua. Do not forget the Quran and the dua, these two elements. These two elements in the month of Ramadan. Number one, Quran, at least one juz, one section of the 30 sections every day or the night, at least one, if not more. And the second, the dua. Remember, there are dua al-sahar, dua al-iftitah, dua Abi Hamza al-Thamali, dua al-jawshan al-kabir, dua al-jawshan al-saghir, many, many duas. The duas after the prayers, ya Aliyu, ya Azim, ya Ghafuru, ya Rahim. And other du'as that we recite, don't forget about them. Read them, read the translation of the du'a. They refine you, they change you. When you read the du'a with reflection, this is a testimony. You are making a declaration, a statement, a vow with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That I'm going to change myself in these areas. Try not to let Shahr Ramadan go without reading a whole cycle of the Holy Quran, with reflection. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. The most powerful element of awakening and refinement, spiritual refinement, is the Holy Quran. Sometimes I meet non-Muslims who tell me that I'm inspired by your book. I love your book, the Holy Quran. He's a non-Muslim. And you come to the Muslims, many of them either they don't read, or even those who read and memorize, they go against the teachings of the Quran. Look at the bombing which is taking place now in Yemen. during the month of Ramadan by a country that prints these Qurans, millions of copies of these Qurans. And this is one of them. By the same company, the same city, the same person, the same country, the same government are bombing the distressed and helpless people of Yemen during the month of Ramadan. This is how we treat the Quran. This is how we treat the Quran. Therefore, the hadith says, رُبَّتَا لِلُّ الْقُرْآنِ وَالْقُرْآنُ يَلْعَنُهُ. How oftentimes someone, he memorizes the Quran and recites the Quran, but the Quran curses him. He says, you are not honest. You read me, you memorize me, but you go against me, against what I am telling you. Exactly against. The Quran says, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. Help each other, protect each other, defend each other. But some people, they choose to bomb each other, to kill each other, even during the month of Ramadan. They bomb the masajid, places of worship. And the third area that we have to work on is our behavior. Behavior with others. Behavior with our families. Today Allah has endowed us with a big responsibility. That responsibility is called your family, your wife, your children, your husband. How are you treated them? How do you treat them? You have to look into that. You have to examine that. If you want your siyam, your fasting, your Quranic recitation, your prayers to be accepted, you have to look into the way you treat your family at home. Do not separate Quran and salat and dua from the way you behave at home. Don't separate. It has to be reflected. The Quran that we learn, the dua that we recite, the prayers that we perform, the lecture that we listen to, the iftar that we give, has to have a positive effect on our behavior. At home, it is unacceptable that we use anger and frustration with our family members during the month of Ramadan, because I'm fasting, leave me alone, I'm fasting. That's not an excuse. We have to change, and the change begins with oneself and his family. And then we go to our friends. The hadith روي عن الإمام الباقر عليه الصلاة والسلام أنه قال, the way we treat others, ما من مؤمنين احتجرا, two believers, two individuals who are believers, مؤمنين, they have a fight between themselves. Fight. احتجرا فوق ثلاث. If they don't speak to each other more than 3 days, إلا برئت منهما, I am going to disavow from them, renounce them. They are not مؤمنين anymore. If the fight continues, if they don't speak to each other more than 3 days, you have a limit. The cap is only 3 days. Maybe within these 3 days you are frustrated, you are angry, but you have to cool down. You have to cool down. Curse the shaitan. Shaitan, he wants to sow the seeds of dissension and hate among your hearts. Curse the shaitan, stay away from the shaitan. A believer, what does a believer mean? Number one character of a believer, he or she must have a pure heart, the purest heart. If your heart is not a pure, if your heart is the center of a grudge, then you are not a believer. Don't waste your time. Don't fast. Believe me, if you ask me, don't fast. Enjoy food and a drink. You are wasting your time. The heart, we have to work on the heart. The heart is the station of love and forgiveness. Yes, we get angry, yes, but not more than 3 days. Illa bari'tu minhuma. Al-Imam al-Baqir says they are not part of us. Don't call your us Shi'i or Muslim or a believer. Then they said to him, فَقِيلَ يَبْنَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ هَذَا حَالُ الظَّالِمِ فَمَا بَالُ الْمَظْلُومِ. Imagine those two, one of them is the aggressor and the other is the victim. So why the victim is not part of us after 3 days? Listen to the Imam. The Imam says, فَقَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ وَمَا بَالُ الْمَظْلُومِ لَا يَصِيرُ إِلَى الظَّالِمِ فَيَقُولُ لَهُ أَنَا الظَّالِمُ حَتَّى يَصْطَلِحَ. Even if you feel you are a victim, of course, in any dispute, when we have dispute with others, are we the aggressors or the victims? Huh? We are always the victims, alhamdulillah. We don't do anything bad. Always people wrong me, I don't wrong anyone. Always, always, always. I have never seen in my life that a husband and wife, they come to me and one of them says, I am the aggressor, she's the victim. Never. Always he's the victim, she's the victim. Imam says, even if you think you are the victim, mazloom, go to him after 3 days, go to him and tell him, I did wrong to you. Even if you think you didn't do wrong, say, I did the wrong. I want to come back to you. Hatta yastaliha, reconcile. They create peace. This is Islam. This is Islam. This is the school of Islam. But if we speak about the school of Daesh, it's something else. It is based on blood and a grudge and hatred and killing. That is the school of Ahlul Bayt. No more. After 3 days, you have to go to him or her and apologize, even if you think you are the victim. That's the way. Hatta yastaliha. Let me conclude with this hadith. Ruwi an al-imam al-ridha alayhi salatu wassalam. Our eighth imam. Annahu qal, yukhfaru fi kulli laylatin fi shahri ramadhan 70,000. Every single night Allah. And 70,000, it's a figure of a speech, a metaphor in the Arabic literature, Arabic language. When we want to mention something, a big number, we say 70. In tastaghfir lahum 70 marra falan. So it's not literally means only 70,000. It could be 7 million. 70,000 Allah forgives every night of Ramadan. فَإِنْ كَانَتْ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ, if لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ, the night of destiny comes, غَفَرَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِيهَا بِقَدَرِ مَا غَفَرَ فِي رَجَبِ وَشَعْبَانَ وَرَمَضَانَ, Allah will forgive in that particular night the same amount that He forgave in these 3 months, Rajab, Sha'ban, and Ramadan, إِلَّا, except someone would put him on hold. They would not forgive him. إلا رجل بينه وبين أخيه شحنا, a person that he has hatred between him and his brother. They put them on hold. They say, sorry, you are on the waiting list. Stay here. Let's see what happens. فيقول تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, انظروا هؤلاء حتى يصطلحوا. Put them on hold until they get back to each other. If they don't get back to each other, leave them there. On the waiting list. Let them wait. This is the month of Ramadan. The month of brotherhood, sisterhood, love, forgiveness. We all are asking Allah to forgive us. If you ask each and every person, what is your prime need? You would say forgiveness. Then you have to forgive each other. Forgive each other. Make it a real month of forgiveness among ourselves so we receive the ultimate forgiveness and mercy and compassion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wal asri inna al-insana lafi khusrin illa alladhina amanu wa amilu al-salihat wa tawasaw bil-haqqi wa tawasaw bil-sabr wa sallallahu wa sallama ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ahli baytihi al-tayyibin al-tahirin.